Strive for perfection, knowing that I could never reach it. But it didn't stop me from trying. If I reach for the moon, I come down with a few stars.
Oh, NBA legend Dwyane Wade is sharing snapshots of his life and career in his new photographic memoir.
He is joining us now. Welcome, Dwyane. Woo! What's going on, man?
What's up, guys?
Hey, congratulations on the memoir. Why now? What made you want to write this, and how did it come to be?
You know, Mario, I feel like it's something that's been getting written for my entire career. You know, I captured a lot of these photos, maybe the last 10, 11 years of my life. I got like 2 million of them. So to try to grab 200 of them, was a hard process for Bob Metellus and I, who is my photographer, you know, on most of these photos. But for me, man, I had 3 things I wanted to do when my career ended in 2019. One was to do the One Last Dance tour, which I was lucky enough to do. One was to do a documentary, and one was to do a photographic memoir. I didn't want to just put words on a paper. I wanted to be able to allow the visuals to express even more than my words could. And I also wanted to give more context to certain moments that fans have maybe seen and some that they haven't.
Yeah.
So a lot of these moments in here, I got some where I'm at home with toast spreaders on, and I'm just being me. And so I just try to take them on a journey of all the support that has been given to me. I wanted to be able to have something that my fans could and my supporters could walk away with and learn a little bit more about me.
Fans are going to love it. I love looking at all the stages. Take us back to this one, 2009, your signature dunk. And I love who we see sitting on the side there, Dwyane.
That is for me, that was a big moment. I had just signed with the Jordan brand leading into that year. Michael Jordan was at the game. And I remember Jordan told me, he said, if you're going to wear my shoes, I need to see them in the air more than I need to see them on the floor.
Ah.
And so I gave him an air moment right there that will forever be in the archives. But playing against Cleveland, playing against LeBron, it was just a big game, big atmosphere, big moment. And that's my favorite dunk of all time that I personally did.
Now, that's a dope pick right there. And your back-to-back championships with the Miami Heat, that's a beautiful pick. And Yeah, that's when he joined you there. He wanted to come up, so he knew what to do.
No, you know, it's a special time, Mario and Kid. I mean, just to be able to, you know, when you're an athlete and you're trying to strive for greatness, not just as an athlete, but you don't have time to sit back and reflect. It's always about the next shot. It's always about the next possession. It's always about the next play and so forth and so on. So being able to put this book together, I got an opportunity to sit down and reflect and sit down and think about, you know, these moments in more depth, more detail, and to be able to share some of those stories for me is something that I'm super duper excited about. And also too, for the people in here, like the LeBrons of the world, the Shaqs of the world, the people who helped me along this journey, to be able to express myself to them as well is something I wanted to do.
Yes.
Speaking of reflecting, the pictures of Kobe in the book, the ultimate competitor, tell everybody about the time you broke his nose.
Uh-oh.
Oh, man, it's one of the worst stories that I have.
Sorry.
You know, it's the competitiveness in guys. And, you know, we're in an all-star game, and Kobe and I are, you know, kind of going at it back and forth. And we're jocking each other. And I just tried to foul him hard like he was fouling me hard. You know, I was just trying to get the ref's attention. Like, yo, he fouled me on the other end. And I ended up breaking his nose. And I remember just feeling so bad about it. And the story goes is, I called Kobe. We were going to LA a few days later. I called him. I'm like, bro, I'm so sorry that I did that. You know, I'm a competitor, but I didn't want to take it that far. And he was just like, nah, it's okay. All good. See you in a couple of days. I love it. Like type energy. And it got me a little nervous on the other end of the line. I ain't gonna even lie. I was like, oh.
You said, uh-oh.
The crazy thing about that is that the All-Star game, no one plays defense. And you out here breaking people's noses. That's a crazy thing.
That's great.
Oh, man.
But I have to tell you, your scene stealer daughter, Kaavia, Shady Baby, I follow her. I can't get enough. Tell us about her. There she is right there. Look at that look right there, Mario.
That's she doing Adele right there.
The Adele Halloween costume.
That's
How
funny.
Did this come about?
Yeah, first of all, my wife had to, we was lucky enough to be a part of Adele's One Night Only. And when we were there, we got a chance to talk to Rich, who was obviously a friend. And we was like, yo, we got something coming for you guys for Halloween. And it really was a homage play to us and just some fun to do of dressing Kaavia and our best friend Crosby up in iconic duels. And there's nothing gets more iconic and more relevant than Adele and Rich Paul at this point. So we just had a little fun with it. And we thank them so much for allowing us to have some fun at their expense. But Kaav nailed it. Did you see the arm on the wall and look back? She nailed it.
The attitude. Look, that little look right there.
She'll probably be singing them tunes any minute now too. Dwyane, your son, Zaire is following in your footsteps.
I'm sure
you're incredibly proud of him, but at the same time, do you ever feel like, oh man, I don't want my kid to have like the pressure because he's my son? I'm sure that's kind of got to go through your mind too sometimes, right?
Yeah, man. You know, it's the unfortunate part of it, right? He's learning a lot about the game of basketball that he's never, you know, learned before about being a pro. So to all his teammates, all the coaches, to Salt Lake City Stars, I'm just thankful for them for this opportunity. And that's all we all need sometimes. Sometimes we just need an opportunity. And he's getting his at the highest level, so I'm excited for him.
Does Kaavia have game? Because my money's on her.
I think Kaavia can do whatever she wants. I just hope that, you know, she allowed me to be there alone to ride. You know, right now she'd be like, Daddy, no. Daddy, don't come in the room. She's really bossy. So I'm trying to stay in her good graces just like everybody else.
I saw her golfing. She's bringing it.
I got bossy girls at home, too. I feel you on that, man.
They're the best kind.
God bless you.
Bossy.
Yeah. Hey, nice to see you, Dwyane. Congratulations on everything, man.
On everything.
Thank you, bro. Good seeing you, bro.
You got it. Thanks to Dwyane. His photographic memoir is available now.
And they just blew us away with their performance on Dancing with the Stars. Olivia Jade and Val are here. That's next.